Amazon's been innovating with AI for decades.
So everyone's talking about AI, but the thing that nobody is talking about is the technology that companies are actually using to build a strong data foundation in order to power AI. And that technology is the data warehouse. Over the last few years, there's been a lot of debate in the data warehousing world. Everything's gotten a lot more competitive since the days of Teradata and Netezza. And these days, every company, regardless of its size or industry, is probably investing in building an internal data warehouse and data platform. When you look at the data warehousing space today, there's really four or five key players that have emerged in this post-cloud analytics world. You've got Snowflake, which is probably the most notable brand in the modern, you know, data warehousing stack. You can think of Snowflake as kind of the easy button for data warehousing. They came into the market and said, all of this is way too complicated and also way too expensive. And there should be an easy way where you can dump a lot of data into a system and just pay for how much you're querying. Databricks is kind of interesting because if you look back to a couple of years ago, Databricks was a very known technology brand, but no one really saw it as a data warehouse. It was a platform for enterprise deployments of this data engineering technology called Spark, as well as where, you know, the data scientists and analysts using machine learning and Python notebooks and stuff like that would hang out. But they came into the market a couple years ago and said, hey, the technology we've built for managing, analyzing, transforming massive amounts of data with Spark can be a data warehouse too. And we can build an offering that's really competitive with Snowflake. And today, you know, they've really risen over the last couple of years as one of the key players in the space. Next up, you have, you know, Redshift, BigQuery, Azure Synapse. These are the solutions that are offered natively in AWS, Google Cloud, and Azure, respectively. So these are the kind of default solutions that you can use if you're a customer of those cloud providers. So Redshift is really the old guard. It's the original player in this, you know, post-cloud data warehouse world. The technology they're really known for was, you know, porting effectively old data warehouse technology to the cloud. BigQuery had the technology that Snowflake has at a very high level from a long time ago, but I think was kind of penalized by the low adoption of Google Cloud and the enterprise in really capturing that market. But over the last 5 years, they've really seen some tremendous growth, especially in certain verticals like retail and gaming. And lastly, Synapse. You don't get fired for buying Microsoft or IBM software. It's just kind of the option that's there in Azure. And I'm not exactly sure how many people are going for this versus stuff like Databricks or Snowflake on Azure these days. You can make the argument that there's other players popping up like the Firebolts or Tabulars or Materializes of the world. But in reality, the ones that I mentioned are the key data warehouses in the enterprise. And these are being used for specialized use cases right now. We'll see how that changes, but that's the case right now. So how are things shaping up? I'll talk about a couple large trends that are happening across the data warehouse market. First, processing engines and languages. When you thought about a data warehouse a decade ago, you thought about SQL database that was optimized for analytics or, you know, OLAP workloads. And you could run really complex SQL queries against it, but SQL was the lingua franca of the data market and the data warehousing market. That was the language used to query the data warehouse, and it operated just like a normal database. When you think about data warehouses today, they're starting to go from data warehouses to broadly data platforms or data clouds, as Snowflake calls it, where they offer tons of different languages you can query them with, different workloads that they support, for example, more transactional workloads or analytical workloads or streaming workloads, ML workloads. And effectively, they're trying to give you more flexibility and really have one platform that you can procure for all your data needs at a company. So one thing that I would say is pretty ubiquitous across the major data warehouses today, especially Snowflake and Databricks, is the ability to use either SQL or programming language like Python, Java, Scala with a Spark-like interface. And what do I mean by a Spark-like interface? Databricks is the company behind Apache Spark, a really popular open source project. And the way you interact with Spark is by actually using these MapReduce-like functions inside of a programming language like Java, Scala, or Python. And Databricks then translates all that code into a really optimized engine that can run on super high scale data spread across tons of machines. Snowflake was effectively doing the same thing with SQL queries as an input. You would give it a SQL query and it would figure out the best optimal way to run that. But SQL can be limiting for certain types of transformations or workloads or programs, and also just cumbersome to use in some cases. So now the sort of standard that I think Databricks really pushed the market to move to is multi-language support in data warehouses, where you can query them in SQL, and you'll probably do that most of the time, but you can also query them in something like Python in a similar way to Spark. So Snowflake calls this Snowpark in their case. Another big trend that we're seeing across the data warehouse market is open table formats. Data warehouses used to be a technology. And when I say used to be, I still mean in, you know, technologies like Snowflake. I'm not just talking about the old data warehouses, but basically they were a technology where you actually put data into them. You can import data from your AWS S3 bucket or CSV files you have, or any sort of blob storage. You're actually putting data into these warehouses, and the warehouse is actually reformatting it so that it can be queried in an optimal way by the data warehouse platform. Now, one problem with this is that the way enterprises are looking to use data is getting more and more complex and sophisticated day by day. We have traditional retail companies who are looking to not only use data warehouses to analyze their data, but are looking to build custom proprietary machine learning models in parallel or do a bunch of data science work. And what happens when you have these different workloads that you want to run on a certain set of data is it's really annoying to have to copy data into another platform to run a certain workload on them. So for example, if you have to copy your data into Snowflake in order to run analyses on that data, then if you want to follow up those analyses with, you know, some machine learning work or data science work that happens in a different platform like Python or Spark or even in a competing technology now like Databricks, that actually requires you to move data in and out of the platform, which incurs a lot of compute costs as well as latency as well as just overhead from a data engineering perspective. It's a lot of work and it becomes something that analysts cannot do seamlessly anymore. The biggest trend we're actually seeing over the last year in the data warehousing space is this idea of an open table format, which means instead of having this proprietary format that a technology like Snowflake or BigQuery would rearrange your data into once you import your data into them, they actually say that upstream of Snowflake in your data platform, put all your data in this format. For example, Apache Iceberg is the open standard for this that Snowflake has recently really been pushing the integration with. And Databricks really led the charge for this initially with Delta Lake. That was their whole differentiator in the data warehousing space at first when they came out. But the idea is you put all your data into one of those formats ahead of time, and you use that as a format that you can use for multiple different workloads. You know, it's data that's in your cloud and an open source format that you can use for Python workloads or data warehousing workloads or any sort of thing around your company. And then instead of Snowflake or any data warehouse copying your data into their data platform and rearranging it, they're actually querying your data in that open table format directly and using your S3 bucket or whatever storage mechanism you give them as the actual source of data and just running their compute on top of it. So is there a clear winner in the data warehousing world? There's all this change, it's all this competition, but who's gonna win? Who's gonna be the Uber of the space and who's gonna be the Lyft of the space? Unfortunately, I don't think there will be a clear winner in the data warehousing market. I think there'll be a lot of competition and a lot of other reasons than technology that goes into why companies choose one data platform or another data platform to really centralize around. And it's not that simple too. Most enterprise companies are using multiple of these data platforms across different parts of the unit. And why does that happen? Well, the decision process at enterprise companies for software in general, not just data warehousing, is and always has been, and probably always will be, based on more than technology. There's questions like, what vendors are we already using today that we can just work with without having to go through the procurement process? What does switching costs look like? For example, I'm not an expert on Azure Synapse, but have they optimized their technology in a way that's really easy to move from if I'm using SQL Server or all the tools built around that by Microsoft? And we see this all the time. You know, I've seen large enterprise customers feel really compelled to use something like Google BigQuery, even if they like some of the technical benefits of Snowflake, because their Google Cloud sales team is giving them Looker, the BI tool that Google acquired, for free if they go with Google BigQuery over Snowflake. Or the same with Synapse and Power BI or any sort of tool in the Azure suite. I don't think there will be a clear winner in the data warehouse market. I think there will be a lot of fragmentation across the market as different enterprises will buy different solutions for different reasons. But I do think that the space will remain to be very competitive. All the players will continue to evolve their technology. And there's a handful of things that every winning data warehouse will have. If I think through those things, I would say, one, they'll be elastic. The old style of, you know, provisioning your data warehousing resources ahead of time, saying you only need a terabyte of storage and 3 CPUs of this type, and having to restart or rearrange your data to upgrade, that stuff's totally out. Every solution is going to be elastic. It's going to be serverless. It's not just going to run in the cloud, but it's going to be, you know, cloud native or rethought for the cloud. And you're just going to have to pay for what you use and not really have to worry about the whole servers and resources element. The next thing that I think every winning data warehouse will have is support for open table formats. I didn't really believe that much in open table formats when Databricks first came out with this a few years ago. But as the data space has evolved and as, you know, new workloads like ML and data science and stuff like that have really been emerging. I truly see the value of it, and I think it's something that's going to be table stakes for any enterprise going forward. And next, I would say, is support for just various workloads. Even if you do support various workloads in a data warehouse, I think the market has spoken and the customers have spoken that you still want open table formats. But at the same time, I think every data warehouse will support some combination of Spark stuff, Python, Java, SQL, versus just being a SQL database. I mean, you can see this going a step further with Snowflake coming in and saying, it's not just multiple languages, but it's multiple compute workloads overall. We're going to support streaming pipelines that you might previously have had to do in something like Confluent or Kafka. And it's not there yet, but I think writing's in the wall that these data clouds are heading that way. And lastly, but not least, and this is overly talked about these days, but I think, you know, any data platform is going to have strong integrations with ML and AI workloads if they're not competing for that market share themselves, which I think will be a big trend in the major clouds like Azure and Google Cloud and AWS. So some closing predictions. There'll be no winner in the data warehouse market, but the technology that companies have access to is better than ever and will continue to iterate due to this steep competition. That being said, the real winners will always be the three major cloud providers, frankly. Even if you're using Snowflake or Databricks, you're running these technologies on top of a cloud provider like AWS, Google, and Microsoft, which are still getting a fair share of the margin and are winning in the end of the day, unless the space dramatically changes and these, you know, software companies like Snowflake and Databricks start getting into the hardware and cloud stack, which I don't see happening.